Hello viewers, today again I have brought 25 more examples of correctness, and today in the same way last time also we have done together, today also I am going to solve 25 correctness here. So without wasting a minute, let's start. The practice session is going on. Because during this lockdown situation, it's very easy way to learn grammar, because if you practice at home every day 20-20 grammar, if you practice, then I think it will help you. So today's 25 examples I have written here, 25 questions, and together we'll solve. So let's start. Correct tense from part 3. First question here, I have written the bell rang after we finish our work. And before, after this topic, this technique, before, after, if any sentence before, after is there, then what you have to do, I will tell you later after completing this one, this 25 exercises. So first you see, you follow me, after is there. After means this portion should be past perfect. Remember, if it is before is there, suppose there before, last time also, if you see my video, then there you will get the before word is there. When before is there, this portion I used past perfect. So after is there, after means this portion where we have to use past perfect. Already is a past tense rang, so we finish our work. So ultimately we had finished. Correct? Complete. Second number you come here, please ring me up. That is called, one term is called in future term. Please ring me up as soon as he comes. Yes, you are correct. As soon as he comes. This is the correct answer. And it is time, third number question, you see, it is time already. I told you, if it is time is there, then what do you have to do? Change into past tense. That is, go is there in the bracket. So you have to make it a past tense, go to went. Question number 4, you come here and see the as if. Again, you follow is as if is the as if means, again, the next bracket word should be past tense. That should be new. Okay, question number 4. It's very easy. If you know the formation and technique, then within a very short period of time, you can complete 100 exercises within 5 minutes. Very easy. Now you see question number 5. If it rain, we shall not go out. So if is there, here if, and here future tense is there. Obviously, this sentence should be present tense. That means called rains. Yes, correct. And 6 number, if I be you, all right? Again, answer is correct. If I be you, I would not have called him again. If I be you, that means if I were. This be, verb to, were. 7 number question, the principal is not in his room. And already I have given one sentence like that. Father is not at home. And the next answer should be present perfect tense. That is called, he has gone out. Finish. Okay. 8 number you see, it rained since 8 o'clock this morning. 8 o'clock this morning. This is called present perfect continuous. And formation you already have learned, I think, that is called have, has, plus been, plus verb, ing. Yes, learn nicely, then you can easily solve it. So here it is the third person, that's why has been raining. Complete. Sheetal play football every day. Sheetal is a third person. And every day is there. Every day is called present tense. That's why third person with the verbs you have to use S or ES. The Sheetal plays. Finish. Sheetal plays football every day. It's called simple present tense. So ultimately in this correct tense, you have to identify the tense. It's very important. If you know the tense and the formation, then I don't think that it will make, you know, panic for solving all these exercises. Anyhow, question number 10, we have went to his house. Again, when? When we have went, what he was doing? When we have went, what he was doing? What he was doing is called past continuous tense, was reading. He was reading. Now come to question number 11. Socrates was taken away to prison by the policeman. Is called passive voice. Socrates was taken away to prison. It's wrong sentence. So answer should be that Socrates was VPP. This should be VPP, passive voice. So it's called taken, not take. It's called taken. Socrates was taken away to prison by the police, by the cops. 12, may he go to Shillong last month? Very simple, last month. Last month is called past tense, yes. And past tense formation is V2. V2 means go is a present tense to you, right? Went. Finished. Again future, shall. So that should be R-A-I-N-S, tense. He did the work since last month. Again, it's since last Monday or Monday last. That means from Monday, today is Wednesday, suppose, Wednesday. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, three days continuously he was working. So ultimately when the work has been started before and still going on, it is called present perfect continuous tense. And formation is subject plus has have plus been plus verbing. So he has been doing. Answer should be has been doing. Complete 14 number. You see within 5 minutes, I think I have completed this 14 number questions. Now come to 15 number question. 15 number again, you see last Friday. Since for Europe is there. But last Friday, that means he, some place is there, before place for is there. So it is not a future tense, it's a present perfect tense, but last Friday, yes, simple past tense. Simple past tense means V2 means leave, L-E-A-V-E, leave. And past form is called L-E-F-T, left. So answer should be L-E-F-T, left. With past tense, simple past tense, so that's why only present form to past form I have to change. Again, you see this 4-6 years now. 4 plus time. The preposition 4 and then time is called present perfect continuous. Present perfect continuous. That's why you have been learning, L-E-A-R-N-I-N-G, learning. Very good. Again, after is there. Already I told after means here simple past tense. Simple past, here past perfect. The simple past went is there, go went. And here past perfect, he locked. That means called had locked. Had plus VPP. Now you fail unless you work hard. Here if not there. You fail. Instead of if, here use unless. Here you see present tense. You work hard. Is a present tense. That should be future tense. You will fail. Okay. You will fail unless you work hard. Clear? Question number 18. Question number 19. The show always begin at 6 p.m. Always, every day, usually, often indicates the sentences present tense. Present tense, verb plus s or es for third person. In present tense, that is because the show is a third person, always begins. Simple. 20 number question. The bus usually arrive here at 6 o'clock. The bus usually, again you see usually, it is also same, this formation. Usually, always, every day, often, etc. indicates is a simple present tense. So ultimately the bus is a third person. So ultimately arrive, it should be A-R-R-I-V-E-S, arrives. Oh, lucky. How lucky you are, you see. Always, usually, again, usually this year. So again, usually if it have, then this go will become my sister is a third person. So ultimately go will become goes. And now very interesting question ahead. You see question number 20, very twisted questions. And I will explain later. I have my dinner before he arrived at her. So here you see before have. After means this side past perfect, and before means here past perfect. This should be should past perfect because here past tense have. So past perfect when you have to make, I have my dinner. That is called I had my dinner. Double had. I had my dinner. Now maybe some questions may arise in your mind. So I will explain here down. Wait 1 minute. Let me complete, then I will explain. Then question number 23rd is we finish our work by Monday next. By Monday next, my dear, this one very important follow. By Monday next, one perfect time has given to complete the work. It's called future perfect tense. It's called future perfect tense. And according to future perfect tense, that is called shall or will plus have plus VPP. This is the formation. Always remember, always try to learn the formation of the tenses. Then it will help you a lot. Now you see, as a future perfect tense, that is called by Monday next, by 7:30 p.m., by tomorrow, is called future perfect tense. That means we shall have finished our work. Next, you see he leave for Calcutta in half an hour. In half an hour. That means he leave for Calcutta in half an hour. That means he is getting ready to move to Calcutta. That means he is going to Calcutta now. But it is written in half an hour. It is called future continuous tense. It's called future continuous. That's why here he will be leaving. Formation is shall or will plus be plus verbing. And next you see by half past six. Again you see by half past. That's called by Monday next and by half past. It's called future perfect tense. Correct? We have our breakfast. That means we shall have had our breakfast. Okay, now I told you that I will explain that last two. One thing you remember, if any sentence before is there or after have. These two words you will get, okay? Then if before you found anywhere, then middle you'll get the before, and first sentence it should be past perfect tense. Past perfect. And this should be simple past tense. This is the formation. Here you have to use had plus VPP. And here you have to write only V2. Just like went. Past tense, just like had gone. But if after is there, after is totally opposite. After is, here should be simple past. Here simple past. Is a simple before is there. So if before is here, then simple past this side. So after is here, then simple past here. And past perfect will come here. PP. Totally opposite. It's totally opposite. Understood? Okay. And next, this question, what I told. Had. No, that one I'm going to explain. Why the answer is had written. Suppose I have completed my dinner before he came. So here you see before have. Before means this portion I have to make a past perfect. So past perfect formation is what? Had plus VPP. Correct? Okay. So question is I have. So I plus had. Subject plus had plus VPP. This is the formation. Subject plus had plus VPP. So question is I have completed my dinner. So I have written, I written here. Then you could subject complete the had. Had. Okay. This is the formation. And then VPP. VPP will come from here. Here will come VPP. So have VPP is have is a present tense. Had is a past tense, and had is a past participle, or is V2 or V3 or is called VPP. So according to formation, I had, now have is there. This have will become had. Okay, that's why I had. If again doubt is there, let me wait. I will explain again. See, suppose here had not there. You did have. Now you see did. So if did is there, then again formation is subject plus had plus VPP. Correct. So subject is I. So I had, formation is there, I had. Now VPP is there. So VPP did is there. Did, VPP is called done. Okay. So I had done. Okay. So like that, I had, and this have was there. And this have VPP is this had. I had. I hope you have understood. Thank you and have a nice day.